Hi, and welcome to this short tutorial on searching ScienceDirect from Elsevier. You can access ScienceDirect from the database list on the library webpage. Make sure that you can see the proper institutional logo up in the far right corner. If you don't, you will probably need to set up the VPN so you can access all the materials. On this first front page, you can use the single search option box right here. You can search for keywords, author names, journal book titles, etc. You can also go into the advanced search option if you need more options to choose from. Please note that the single search option right here puts automatic and between search terms. So if you search for machine learning, it will search for machine and learning in all documents. If you want to avoid this, you can put double quotation marks around the search terms that you want to explore. So if you just click search or hit enter, it will retrieve documents that matches machine learning as a phrase. So that means that machine and learning must be placed next to each other, right, like so. If you want to include more search terms, you can go up here in the search field and just enter more search terms, or you can use the advanced search option. If you click into the advanced search, you need to, unfortunately, put it in all again. So we'll do machine learning. And if I want to add a search term, like algorithm, I can now click search or hit enter, or I can specify even more what I want to, or where I want to search. So now it says it's set to all fields. It's probably a better idea to narrow this to abstract title keywords in both options, because then it will only look for these words in the abstract title or keywords in the books and journals. This means that the retrieved results will probably be of more interest to you. You can also further narrow by holding it up to a particular field like computer science. But in this case, it's pretty obvious that's what we're looking for, so I don't want to do that right now. You can also define the date range that you want to look for documents from. So you can say that you want to have from 2010 to present. And then you can use the search button right there. This will retrieve a list of journals and book chapters that matches your search term. In the left menu, you can further add more topics, or you can use publication title to limit the number of documents retrieved. If you know you're looking for something from journal, you can tick the box for journals under content type and then just use apply filters right there. It is sorted by relevance, but you can also sort by date if that's preferable to you. In the list, you'll also see that some of these, or most of them, are marked with a green label. That means that we have full text access in our subscription package. Then it means that you can directly download it, the full text. If it's marked by red, that means that we do not have the full text access, and that means we have to order it in for you. Please contact the library and we'll be able to help you. If I want to have a closer look at the articles, I'll be able to click the title and then I'll get the entire text. I can also download the PDF to save it on my local computer, or you can use the export functionality and then just export the data to your citation manager. It's done right here. If I wanted to go back and have a look at more of the articles, you can also, to save some time, I would recommend that you use the abstract button before you download the PDF. You can have a quick look at the abstract and see if it's interesting to you. And if you want to download or export several articles in one go, you just tick them right here and then use the export functionality to get it into EndNote or your preferred reference manager. This was a quick look at some of the search options in SoundsDirect. So if you have any questions, please contact your local library. Good luck.